Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Madam Secretary, you were both a state and federal prosecutor. Did you ever approve or sanction investigations that allowed gun walking?
No, not to my knowledge.
Why would you not allow gun walking?
Well, I don't think those matters or those kinds of investigations were ever presented to me.
But had they been presented to you, there's a reason you don't allow contraband, cash, and guns to walk. As a former federal and state prosecutor, can you give us those reasons?
Well, I don't like to speculate. You know,
I'm not asking you to speculate.
Every prosecutor makes different decisions, and I don't believe I was ever presented with that decision.
So you can't think of any reasons not to let contraband walk outside the care, custody, and dominion of a law enforcement officer?
Well, I think in the common context, when you, in drug cases or firearms cases or whatever, when you are trying to work the case up, you know, from the low level to the higher levels and put somebody who's a more serious criminal off the streets, oftentimes you let contraband get into the hands of others.
And then you immediately interdict it and arrest them. I've did it for 16 years, Madam Secretary. You never let drugs, cash, or guns walk. You immediately interdict them. When did you learn of Fast and Furious for the first time?
I learned of it after the death of Agent Terry.
And when did you learn that gun walking was part of Fast and Furious?
I would say sometime between his death and the early spring.
To your knowledge, has anyone ever communicated or did anyone communicate with Mexican authorities that guns were being allowed to cross our border into Mexico in contravention of their gun laws?
I can only speak for communications that I know of, and I know of no such communications.
When you were the United States Attorney in Arizona, did you make routine use of proffers, 5K1.1s, and Rule 35s?
Sure.
So there's no prohibition in the District of Arizona from using the same investigatory and prosecutorial tools that we use in every other district?
Not that I know of.
So there's no reason that this, quote, gun trafficking case could not have been handled like it is handled in all the other states?
I'm not commenting to this one. I'm not second-guessing Fast and Furious that's under investigation now.
Everyone else has second-guessed it. The Attorney General has said there were problems. The President has said there were problems. So I'm not asking you to say anything they haven't already said. Do you agree there were problems with Fast and Furious?
I thought you were asking a much more specific question. But what I would say is, obviously, there were problems with Fast and Furious.
What were those problems?
Well, obviously, you don't want to let guns with the kind of firepower that we now know were involved to get out of your control.
Is firepower the only reason you don't allow guns to
walk? Well, there's a number of them, but if you want to cross-examine me about
it. I'm not cross-examining you, Madam Secretary. I'm asking you about Fast and Furious. I'm asking
you
when you knew about it.
What I'm explaining to you is that the case itself and the matter in which it was handled is under the jurisdiction of the Inspector General. But obviously, from a what we know perspective, yeah, there were problems, absolutely.
When you were the United States Attorney in the District of Arizona, did you ever have Title III cases?
T3s, yes.
And those applications were approved by whom?
The court.
And ultimately, before they got to the court, they had to be approved by the Department of Justice, correct?
Well, yes.
So for the Department of Justice to contend in a Title III OCDEF case that they did not know about Fast and Furious would be disingenuous at best, correct?
I am not going to comment to that. I don't know those specifics. That was not within the Department of Homeland Security.
Well, I'm asking you as a former prosecutor who did T3 cases, the Department of Justice has to approve those applications, correct?
That is the procedure, yes.
And in those applications is a narrative or summary of the case.
That is correct, yes.
So someone at the Department of Justice had to know about Fast and Furious for the T3 to ever have been approved. Correct.
I just can't comment. I don't know that there was a T3 approved in Fast and Furious.
If there were a T3 approved in Fast and Furious, and there were, the Department of Justice would had to have known about it. Correct.
I'm going to leave that for your own investigation, sir. I'm just not going to comment or go beyond what I know. And what I know is that after the death of Agent Terry, the Fast and Furious label became apparent, and we became knowledgeable about it. Obviously, there were problems with the operation. Obviously, it did not succeed, and the Inspector General has that under investigation right now. From a law enforcement perspective, yes, Fast and Furious is very troublesome.
Mr. Chairman, if I might could have just an additional 30 seconds, which may be the custom this morning.
Without objection.
Madam Secretary, my point on Fast and Furious is that there weren't just problems. It was flawed from its inception. Any investigation that countenances gun walking across the border is flawed in its inception. So what I take offense at is when the Attorney General and others on the other side of the aisle say that only when problems became apparent, this investigation was a problem from the very beginning. I'm going to ask you one final question, because you mentioned twice this was an ATF investigation. It was, in fact, an OCDEF investigation, which means what as a former U.S. attorney?
Well, it means, now you're into something I really don't know anything about. I don't know whether it's OCDEF, whether it was handled by an AUSA. I really don't know that.
Would the gentleman yield?
If it were OCDEF, then there would be more than one federal law enforcement agency involved, correct? That's by definition.
I just can't comment to that. I just don't know the answers to that.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Chairman's time has expired.